conditioners in and everything is working. And no air conditioners or seniors were thrown out the second story windows while we tried to install them. Actually, my husband and I are not seniors yet, but we'd like to reach seniorhood. So thankfully we did not fall out the window while dangling out trying to suspend the air conditioners. And it's kind of funny on that note, my husband and I are shopping for a new car. We currently have two Toyota Yaris's, which are like smaller, like about 6 inches smaller than a Corolla. They get good gas mileage, and we've got over 130,000 miles on both of them. One of them's 7 years old, one of them's 9 years old. So my husband decided that we would replace one of the cars. So we've been going car shopping. And we stopped at this one place, and the guy was really nice, but he said, you know, you could get it with all the options on this car, because, you know, this might be your last vehicle. And my husband and I are looking at each other going, I don't think so. We're only in our 50s. And you should have seen the guy backpedal at that point, trying to get out of what he had said. We were like cracking up laughing because, you know, but yeah. So anyway, we're still shopping around for the cars. So hopefully this next week we will end up with something new. Yeah. So it'll be exciting. So when we go on vacation, we won't be riding in a little squished up space. More room for yarn to come home with me in the trunk. So last week, if you watched the episode, you saw that I won a giveaway that was on the podcast Must Love Yarn. And the items in the prize arrived. And so I am going to actually insert that right away, because before I can even show you my finished object or my works in progress, because they've been living in the project bag that was sent. So I don't want to spoil the surprise. So without further ado, here comes the unboxing. It arrived on Thursday, and at first I thought, well, I'll just wait till Saturday and I'll unbox it during the podcast. And then I went, no, because I'm like a kid at Christmas. The package was sitting there all day long calling my name. We were busy putting the air conditioners in, so I couldn't go down and rip the bag open and look inside. So finally that evening, I actually recorded it ahead of time because I couldn't wait anymore. So as I said before, we're going to insert the clip now. So here it is. Must Love Yarn, the giveaway. In case you missed last week, I was the winner in the 1,000 subscriber giveaway on the Must Love Yarn podcast. Must Love Yarn is a yarn shop up in Shelburne, Vermont. It's a really pretty area. My husband and I have been up to that area several times, but I didn't know there was a yarn shop there, or it might not have even been open when we were there, because that's maybe 5 years ago. So anyway, I entered into their 1,000 subscriber giveaway, and I won. That's the first time I've ever won anything yarny in my life. So I'm really excited, and I have not opened this. This came in this afternoon, and I have been very anxious to get into it, but I had to have time to sit down and set my camera up and everything. So we're gonna look at this together for the very first time. So, my scissors here. All right, here we go. I'm not even going to look. I'm going to pull out a thing at a time. Oh, yay. Look at this. We're going to be starting with the project bag. Look how adorable that is. It's got a little pocket. That is so cute. The owner of the yarn shop is named Kelly, and I know her mom makes some of these bags, so I don't know if this is one that her mother made or not, but it's adorable. Look at this. It's got little sheep, and they're knitting, and there's little stockings and little balls of yarn. That is so adorable. This is like my first professional project bag too. I mean, I have ones that I've made, but I've never actually bought one. So let's get started with the yarn. This is, it's called Dream Starry Sock Weight with Silver. It's got stellina in it. And the color is Wisterius. See if I can get this to pick up. Oh yeah, that's picking up really well. Look at the sparkles in there. It's like a tonal purple, and you guys know how much I love purples. That is gorgeous. So that's the first one. It's a sock weight, like I said, and 450 yards. So yeah, I can do a lot with this. It's soft too. It is 90% Australian merino wool superwash, 2% silver fibers. So yes, it has found a good home. Now we'll see what's in the next one. This is Voolenvine, guys. Look at that. Is that gorgeous or what? Look at the pink. I love pink. And there's some pretty blue here. It's kind of like a denim blue. It's showing up purple here, but it's a denim blue. Oh, this is gorgeous. This has been like on my yarn bucket list, was some Voolenvine yarn. And this is from the Art Nouveau Yarn Club from October 2014. And it's called Yellow Dress. It is 80% superwash BFL and 20% nylon. And there's 400 yards in it, and it's a fingering sock weight also. But look how absolutely gorgeous this is. Oh, I'm so excited. Voolenvine yarn. I could check one thing off of my list of must-haves, must-tries. Oh, this, guys, this is beautiful. This is like a magenta purple, and it is 100% super fine alpaca. It feels like alpaca. It is like super, super soft. It has a real light halo to it. Oh, but it's gorgeous. Absolutely beautiful. And this is a fingering weight also, I believe. It say on here? It looks like a fingering. It's by yarnandsoul.com. So, yes, it doesn't say if it's a fingering or a sock weight, but it basically is. I can tell just by the looks of it, but that's what that is. But it's gorgeous. Like I said, it's a magenta purple. Definitely a magenta purple. And extremely soft. Yay, I am so excited. But there's something else in here. As if that wasn't enough. There's more things in here. Oh, cool. It's a must love yarn pin. That's going to go in my project bag. That is so cool. Can put it right there on the pocket. Oh, that is neat. Oh, and then they sent me a must love yarn ruler. All of this will fit just perfect in the pocket. Oh, this is great. So, and their website is www.mustloveyarn.com. And then here is, I think this is a sticker maybe? Or is it a card? It almost feels like a sticker, but I think it's just a card. There's their card. If you haven't checked out their podcast before, do it, because it's a lot of fun. It's two ladies. One is the yarn shop owner. The other, Angela, works in the shop. And they're a lot of fun to watch and just to see what they're up to each week or whenever they podcast. I enjoy it. And I am very, very excited. So Kelly and Angela, if you happen to watch this, thank you so much from the bottom of my heart. I am just so excited about this and looking forward to this. I could knit. This is one of those bags you stick on your arm. And you can put your yarn inside here, and you can knit and walk. Well, most people could knit and walk. I could not knit and walk. I'd probably trip and impale myself with the needles. But I could do it in the car. I could wear this on my arm, and then the ball of yarn won't fall over and get underneath my husband's feet while he's trying to drive the car. That's kind of a bad thing. But this is gorgeous. Oh, look at it. I didn't show you the inside. the inside is like little, like flowers. Yeah, it looks like roses. See if I can get it better. Look at that. That's gorgeous. So pretty. So, I'm excited. Thank you once again, Kelly and Angela. Made my day. Thanks. Okay. This was a sticker, by the way. After I recorded it, I started looking at it in the light a little bit better. And yes, it is a peel and stick sticker. So I'm not sure where I'm going to stick it. It's going somewhere, maybe on my laptop or maybe, I don't know, someplace in my craft room. But yes, so there's my Must Love Yarn sticker. So on to finished objects that, like I said, have been living in my project bag. Isn't that gorgeous? I mean, look how cute that is. Little sheep. You know me and sheep. I love sheep. So this is what the back looks like. More little sheep knitting all kinds of little socks and scarves and mittens. And I've got my Must Love Yarn pin on the front. So everything that I've been working on has been living here. So I finished one project. I bought this yarn, I have no idea how long ago, a couple years ago, I guess. And I didn't know what to do with it because I only bought one skein of the yarn. And this is the strangest yarn I've ever seen. I'm looking to see where the rest of it is to see if I can show you what this looks like. It is Ella Ray Toowoomba. Why would you name yarn that? I have no idea. But anyway, that's what it's called. And the color choice on this was, does it even say? I don't even see a color on this. Here's what it is though. And this is the yarn that is like, it's not plied. It's actually like a woven strand. That's kind of what it is. I had about that much left. I had it up here someplace, and I can't find it anywhere now, but anyway, this is what it is. I knitted this in a basket weave pattern, and it has a little button here. I bought my husband a Father's Day present. I bought one for myself, too. We go to church on Sundays, and we're always lugging, like, really big Bibles. And I like something like, I'm usually carrying a ton of stuff when I go in anyway, so it would be nice to have something little it's not so little that I could actually read the print. So I found this size in large type. Yeah. So I not only bought one for my husband, I bought one for me. So then I thought, well, I need to have some place to put it. So that's what I made. It's a little Bible case here. I'm thinking I need to readjust. I think I need buttons. I think I need a button here and here because it's wanting to pop open. But anyway, that is my finished object. And it knit up quick because I did this on like 6mm needles. And I think I worked on it maybe day and a half, something like that. It was pretty quick. And like I said, it was a small skein of yarn. I've had it, didn't know what to do with it. There was only 104 yards total. And I've got maybe 3 yards of it left. That's about it. So that is my finished object. Other projects that I have been working on, I've added a few more squares to my cozy memory blanket. There it is. I still haven't totally decided. I know I had mentioned that I was going to make it into a cozy memory sweater, but yeah, kind of clownish. I don't think that's going to happen. But I am going to change one thing on this blanket. If you watch So Sweet Violets, she's made a gorgeous one. It's all in pastels. I've got really bright colors. But if you notice the lines that go in here, which is where the miter is created, all of mine go one direction, as you can see here, minus the yarn that's hanging over. There, you can see they all go in the same direction. Hers actually go out almost in a starburst shape, you know, kind of like this, like four corners and go out. So I think once I finish this last square right here, I'm going to start the next section and this, instead of the miter's running this direction, they'll run this direction. So they actually, the miters will actually come to a point. So that's my goal with this. And the yarn that I have here, this was some yarn that I had left from a hitchhiker shawl that I made. This is the yarn that I did my bendy arrow with, which is, it's called Barn Roof. This is the khaki colored yarn that I used in my Find Your Fade. These two colors were in my Banner Unfurled, the turquoise one that I made. And this last one here was yarn that I got from a lady that's a hand dyer on eBay. It was like she sent a group of, I think it was 25 minis or 20 minis for $25. I think it was 20 minis for $25, something like that. So this is one of her yarns. And this is some leftover Ella Ray that I had from some hats I made a few years ago. So that's the row that I've added in the last probably 2 weeks. So that's my project there. Then I have something, I've been working on another design, another shawl design, and I am using Knit Picks yarn for it. It is going to be an asymmetrical shawl, and it's going to be in different shades of yellow and gold, into gold, and then it has a little pop, I think I'm going to put a little pop of cranberry in it. So this color is called Custard. And this is a fingering weight. This is called Custard. This is Semolina. This is Turmeric, or Turmeric. This is Brass Heather. It's really not as orange as it's looking. And this is called Garnet Heather. So I'll hold these up together. That's what it's going to hopefully look like when it's finished. Now, I was talking to one of my subscribers, Carol, and we were talking about ripping things out. And I just want to give you proof, Carol, that I do rip things out on a regular basis, unfortunately. See all the yarn here that's been rewound on? That's stuff that I've actually knitted and ripped back out from this design. And this is all the further I am right now because I've ripped it out. I think I counted 9 or 10 times at this point. So yeah, I'm like at the very beginning cast on. I've been this far and ripped out and this far and ripped out. In fact, here's my cheat sheet for writing the pattern. And you'll see. Written, ripped out. My phone is ringing. Okay, we're back. My telephone always rings. If you've ever watched Legacy Knit Fiber, podcast. It never fails when they're in the middle of the podcast. Their cuckoo clock goes off and they all sit there. It's just going cuckoo. They sit there and do this and it's hysterical. I should do that for my phone because inevitably nobody will call all day long and the phone rings when I'm in the middle of the podcast. Anyway, back to what I was showing you. Here is first attempt rip out, second attempt ripped out, third attempt ripped out, fourth. Then we go over to this side. We got 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9 rip outs, and I've still only progressed this far. Yeah. So anyway, Carol, you are not alone in ripping things apart. I do it all the time, and this one's been a major frustration because every time I would rip it out or think I liked it, I would look at something and go, oh, I want to change this, and I'd rip the whole thing out, or I'd notice I had a yarn over in the wrong spot. You know, it happens to all of us, and it's happened in abundance to me this week. So the last thing that I have been working on has been the knit along that I'm working on for the cowl that we're doing on the Banner Unfurled, which is the pattern I designed. This one is for my daughter-in-law. So Renee, if you're looking, close your eyes for a minute. This is how far I've got. I do not have a progress keeper in this because the yarn, the pattern calls for a fingering weight, and I'm actually experimenting and trying it with a lace weight. So I'm having to like modify the pattern as I go to put more stitches on. And the yarn is just so, so very, very fine, as you can see here. It's so very fine that I'm afraid if I put on a progress keeper, the weight of it could snag it or pull the stitches funny. But this is how far I am right now. I am just getting into, there's a stripe section that comes in here next. And the third color that's going to go with this is in my acquisition, so I will wait and I'll show you it when I get to that point. So this is like a variegated denim color, and this is a gray, which is, there's a little bit of gray in this. You can't see it real good. You can see a little bit right there. And then this is gray here. So I'm into the striping section. And on that note, just for those of you who are interested, the CAL is running until July 30th, and if you enter the CAL now, you could not only qualify for my knit along for this pattern, but Three Sisters Knit is also doing a knit along for this pattern, and theirs runs from June 15th until the end of August. So you could qualify for both of them and double dip. So the prizes for my CAL, and if you do order the pattern to do the knit along, if you enter the discount code KC20, it will give you 20% off. So, and who doesn't like a bargain? So, you know, it'll give you about 80 cents off of the pattern. The pattern's normally $4, so it'll give it to you for $3.20. So here's the project bag. Like I said, those of you who watch every week have seen this thing over and over, but I did change something this week. I was not real happy with the pole that I had before. It just kept snagging and hanging up because of where the seam was, and I just didn't like it as well. So this is actually a ribbon in the same kind of hot pink color, and that way I was able to put an end cap, on the drawstring, and then it has, so you can pull it shut, and it has a little slide that comes down and will hold it shut for you. So it comes with some stitch markers and a progress keeper, and it it comes with primrose yarn in blueberry jazz. And like, the only thing you have to do to enter my knit along is when you finish the pattern, post a picture in the Ravelry group and tell me what kind of yarn you used. And that will enter you, and I will be drawing a winner on July 30th and announcing it on July 31st. So that is the knit along. Now I can show you the other, my yarn acquisitions, and I will show you what I got to go with the two colors that I'm doing my daughter-in-law. So here's the two colors that we had, and then I got this white to go with it as well. And this is yarn that I've talked about before. I've gotten it off of eBay. It is called Urdu's. And I actually like this yarn. You get it for like $3 or so. I skein it. This is lace weight, but it is wool. It's extremely soft. I've been knitting with it. I'm very happy with it, you know, other than I need a magnifying glass to knit, and I feel like I'm knitting on a set of toothpicks. I used to knit lace all the time and on tiny needles, but as I'm getting older, the bifocals just aren't doing it for me anymore. This is the third one. So these are the three colors that are going to be in mine. And I haven't decided, it gets 46 millimeter beads that get beaded into the pattern. I haven't decided what colors to go with. I think this is the color that is going to fall where the beads go. So I have not figured out yet if I should put, I'm thinking if I can get some denim color beads, that would look prettier than gray beads, especially since my daughter-in-law likes blue. So I'm hoping to find some denim color 6 millimeter beads. So I will be putting those together for it. And let's see, what else did I get? I have some more. I didn't buy any fancy yarn this week. I decided I wanted some more dish towels because they're great for knitting in the car. They're just, it's a little project that I can now carry in my project bag. So I got some more of the peaches and cream, and this is how the colorway is, blue and white basically. It's just called denim twists, or twists denim. So anyway, that's all it is. So I'm going to make a couple more dish towels out of that. And then I was talking to my sister-in-law. My brother and my sister-in-law just bought a house and they're going to move in the beginning of July. So I thought, well, I'll make her some dishcloths for them as a little housewarming present and get a couple dish towels to go with it. So I said, well, so what color is your kitchen? She tells me yellow with burgundy or like cranberry color. I went, oh, okay. And then I look at the shawl I'm knitting. Yellow, burgundy. We have a theme going here. I haven't named the shawl yet. I have no idea what I'm going to name it. I might have you guys help me name it. I'm half tempted to call it Jackie's Kitchen after her kitchen, because it turns out the colors are the same. But I just bought some plain. I could not find yellow and burgundy in the sugar and cream. I called it peaches and cream. It's sugar and cream. I couldn't find it in that color. So I just got solid yellow. And then I will hope to find some tea towels or something that have this color and burgundy together in them for her. So that being said, I thought I would update everybody on my vacation plans. And this was cute too. If you check out the Must Love Yarn podcast, which is the giveaway that I won, it's their podcast and they also have a yarn store. The two ladies in it in this latest episode knitted these two adorable sheep hats. And like I said, you know I like sheep. And it is called the Sheep Love Hat. I've got to get a pattern of this. It's got little sheep all the way around, just above the brim, like where the band would be. I'm just hoping I can wear it. I guess I have to knit it big, because I either have a fat head, or maybe it's, I would love to think that it's full of a big brain, but I sort of doubt that. But any time I put, like, even when I was a kid, anything with elastic, like headbands when I was little, and stocking hats and things, if they're the least bit snug around my head, it gives me a headache. I guess it's squishing my brain. I'm not sure, but I'm hoping to make one of those because it's really, really cute. So I've got to look through my yarn stash because I'm sure I've got some stuff that would work, except I think I'll do the little sheep in something fuzzy so they look like fluffy sheep. So check out the pattern and the podcast, Must Love Yarn, and you'll see the hats. But that's something I would like to make at some point between now and the wintertime when I could use it. So we were talking about my vacation plans, and I've mentioned before, we're going up in the fall to Connecticut and Rhode Island. And so my vacation plans include hitting some yarn shops. So when I first started on this little journey, I had 3 pages of yarn shops in the Connecticut, Rhode Island area, which I knew were going to get narrowed down because at that point I didn't know exactly where we were going. As it is, we're pretty much sticking along the coast and then coming back. Now, Rhode Island will kind of go around because Rhode Island's little and, you know, it's doable. But as far as Connecticut goes, we've gone up to other areas of Connecticut before, but this time we're going to stay pretty much along the coastline. So what I did, I went through and circled or highlighted the yarn shops that fall along the 95 corridor. So that's where I'm at with my vacation plans now. As I've done that, and then on those sites, I've actually gone online and I find out if they don't have, some of these shops sadly have gone out of business, or they either don't have a Facebook page or they don't have a website, and I'm not calling all of these places, you know, if they're not like upfront and, you know, obvious, I'm not going to go search them out. But, I've gone online to the ones that do have the Facebook pages or a website to check their hours, because I find that a lot of yarn shops are closed on Mondays and sometimes Mondays and Tuesdays. So that's going to affect whether we stop on the way going up or on the way coming back. So I've gotten that far, so at this point, and as I plan along, I will update you. But that's as far as I've gotten at this point with the vacation plans. Another thing that I've been doing when I go onto these websites is I'm looking to see what kind of yarn they have, because I don't want to buy something I can get at my local yarn shop. I'd rather give her the business than buy it from somebody else. So I'm looking for things that I can't get down here, or I don't see, or I'd have to buy online and then pay shipping. So I thought I would share with you my yarn wish list. I got my one wish granted with the Voolenvine yarn. Yeah, that was on my bucket list. I also want to check out Sweet Georgia Yarns. I've heard lots of podcasters talk about it, and I haven't seen what it, you know, I want to see what the hoopla is about it. So I want to check out Sweet Georgia, Quince & Co., which are actually, when I went online and looked at them, they're very reasonably priced. So yeah, I'm hoping to like see it firsthand. Wonderland Yarns and Hedgehog Fibers. Then there's some other specific things. I'm always looking for, I guess you'd call them souvenir yarns. It's yarn that is dyed by a local dyer to that area. So I'm looking for those. And I'm also, when I go to Peter Patch's yarn warehouse, I'm definitely going to be looking for some white yarn or a crew color yarns that I can dye, because it's cheap. When we were there last year, I think it was like $8 for 2 pounds of wool. So you can't get it a whole lot cheaper than that. It was 1 pound. It was $8 a pound, and you had to buy them in 2 pound lots. So $16 and you got 2 pounds of yarn, which is like a crazy amount of yarn. I could knit sweaters for my entire family and probably have leftovers. But I thought if I can get it cheap enough in white, that will give me a lot of yarn that I can experiment with the dyeing with the food coloring, which is what I've been doing. But if I mess up and it's more expensive yarn, it's, you know, a little sad. So I'm hoping to get some cheaper yarn that I can play with and have fun, and if it doesn't work out, I'm not going to be heartbroken over it. So those are my things on my wish list, and I think that is the end of our podcast. So I'm sitting up in our newer, cooler room. Oh, I remembered one more thing with our window air conditioners. We went to go put the two windows together, and there's a gap in between, you know, when you lift your windows up, there's a gap between the front window and the window in the back. So we decided maybe we should put something in there to keep any air from leaking out. So I had this great idea of pool noodles in this little swimming noodles. So we went to the yarn, or to the yarn store, yes. Yarn on the brain. We went to the dollar store because I knew I'd seen pool noodles at the dollar store. So there we go. I run in, I grab a pool noodle. My husband and I are walking around looking at other stuff. I've never had so much fun with a pool noodle in my life. Actually, I've never played with a pool noodle before, but I had a lot of fun in the dollar store, because every time my husband turned his back, I smacked him with the pool noodle. And then he grabbed one and started smacking me back with the pool noodle. Then we started dueling with the pool noodle and looked up and realized the security camera was like watching us, probably going, look at those strange people. They're having senile moments, you know, these two seniors chasing each other around with pool noodles. I know. Totally immature. But it was fun. Like I said, most fun I've ever had with a pool noodle. So that is it for this week. And I hope to see some people posting soon with your patterns. Like I said, the cow's going to run till the end of next month. And good luck with it, and happy knitting. See you later. Bye-bye.